What I love about my farmer friends is their dedication and integrity. Our farmers have an absolute resolve for doing things right, doing right by nature, and doing right by the produce and animals that grace their land. As I drive up Providence Farms, I hear the cacophony of mooing. It's the sound of happy cattle waiting to enjoy a feast of fresh grass, free of artificial pesticides or chemicals. Matt Millar, one of my favorite local chefs, introduced me to Mike and Providence Farms several months back, and we have been working with them ever since. We're here today to select an animal for the harvest feast. At Mike O'Brien's Providence Farms, he and his wife and their daughter Rose raise 100% grass-fed beef, as well as pastured lamb, pork, chicken, and turkey.
15 years ago or so, my wife and I were living in France. She had some health issues, and that led us to eating food that was locally raised. We started off with a few brood cows, beef cows, raised the calves, learned and appreciated the putting them out on pasture and letting them be animals as they're supposed to be rather than in confinement. And we added on the other animals. We came to appreciate the symbiosis of the species working together.
Mike's guiding principle is that a diverse, rich, chemical-free pasture will produce the healthiest and most delicious meats you can find. If nature doesn't produce it, they don't use it. As a result, you enjoy food that is more delicious, healthier, and kinder to the animal and the environment, and everyone wins.
The animals should be diverse. The plants should be diverse. There should be a lot of different things working in harmony. It feeds the soil, it feeds the animal, and ultimately it feeds us with a better product. The alternative is to take these beautiful, shiny animals, stick them in a feedlot, standing knee-deep in their own manure, and feed them corn, which they were never intended to eat. Cattle, as a four-stomached animal, are meant to digest grasses. The real injustice in the animal world that becomes so evident is a confinement pig versus an outdoor pig. When you see these guys doing what they're doing right now, and you think about sticking that same animal in a building on a metal slatted floor with no windows, no air, no sunshine, and more importantly, no vegetation to eat, you really realize how incorrect, how wrong confinement feeding is.
As I live my life here in this marvelous area and work in conjunction with the natural cycle of the land, I've noticed some very important things. Farmers here don't make demands of the land. They nurture it with love and respect.